Joyce Moore, breast surgeon here at Sky Ridge Medical Center. Standard of care for prevention is what can we do to lower the risk for breast cancer? And some of the things that we can do that can lower our risk is take control of our diet, eat a plant-based diet, okay? Lower in animal proteins, but mostly plant-based. Second thing is keep our weight in a normal range, keep our BMI toward our normal range. Activity. Exercise activity is very important, even separate from the weight control. So activity, exercise. Keep our alcohol intake down to one drink or less for a woman a day. Less is fine. There's no reason you have to drink alcohol, but if you're going to drink alcohol, one drink or less per day equivalent. And the final thing is decrease your stress levels. It's really hard to do that. How do you objectify that? Well, you can do things like volunteer, for instance, at the Nine Health Fair. But volunteering, doing activity exercises, meditation, being with family, socializing, things like that can help decrease your stress levels, and that can help your immune system and make you less likely to have breast cancer. The other thing we do from a medical standpoint is tamoxifen. Tamoxifen can lower a woman's risk of breast cancer if she's high risk. But that's something you need a prescription for and need to talk to your doctor about and, you know, consult with that one. Removing the breast tissue is another option for lowering risk. But again, that usually applies for women who are high risk. And that is determined, again, in consultation with your physician to see, you know, how high is your actual risk and what are the things you can do. Standard of care for treatment. Standard of care for treatment. From a surgical standpoint, let's start with surgery. There are lumpectomies or breast conservation where the breast is preserved. We take out the tumor, we sample lymph nodes, and then radiation therapy is done after that treatment. The other option for surgical treatment is mastectomy, either one side or both, but that's removal of the entire breast tissue, and then reconstruction. It's important for women to know they can have reconstruction so that they don't feel like they've been deformed, if you will. So reconstruction and mastectomy is another option for treatment. Standard treatments for breast cancer in general usually include three basic things. Surgery, which we talked about, chemotherapy, which is done for some patients, not all patients need that, and then radiation therapy. And radiation therapy is not needed for every patient, but for some. So those are the basics. Hormone blockers are something else you're going to hear about. Hormone blockers are for patients who have estrogen progesterone positive tumors, and they're given a pill that they take once a day. So those are pretty much the standard of care. I think geographical barriers is the first one, meaning they aren't close to the resources they need, so they tend not to go in to get their mammograms or tend not to go in to seek treatment because it's a journey for them and hard to get to. I think probably the biggest barrier is probably economics. For patients who don't have insurance or have poor insurance, they're worried about the financial impact of getting a diagnosis or even getting screening on their lives. But I think it needs to be clear that there are resources out there for patients. There are ways to get mammograms at low or no cost. There are ways to get treatment that can be covered.